Disclaimer for YouTube. Let's talk about this. Hi, my name is Martis. I make daily video about intellectual property, legal, and business. What is intellectual property? Think about copyright, trademark, and other intellectual property. In this video, we're going to talk about copyright disclaimer. I'm going to give you something that you can use on your YouTube channel or on your video. You can use it in your description, doesn't matter what you want. And the thing is, it's important to know what you're going to use and how you're going to use it. So in this video, I want to tell you what a disclaimer is and how you can use this disclaimer and what you need to watch out for. So let's go to the drawing board. And disclaimer is just a statement. It's something you need to be aware of. It's just a statement, it's just something you say. Can be true, it can be, cannot be true, it doesn't matter, it's just a statement. Contract, an agreement on the other hand, is a contract. So you have a contract, someone signed it, you sign it, and both of you guys have a contract. So a party, let's say we have A here and B, they have a contract, both parties signed the contract. And this claim is something you warn people about. It can be sometimes good, it can be sometimes bad. That's something you need to be aware of. If you have copyright on something, yes, you can put on your website or on the music, hey, I have copyright on this video, or hey, I have copyright on this music, or I have copyright on this website. You can put it on your website. That doesn't mean it's true. So what you need to understand is most people use disclaimer just to scare people also, like, hey, I have copyright on this. If you use this, there's a risk that you will be sued. It's that simple. So, I don't really believe in copyright, but sometimes I think it's better to put copyright on it so you can scare people off not to use your content. If you have a channel and you're a creator, you can put it. It's not necessary, yeah? Because as soon as someone uses your content without your permission, you can sue them, and you don't need a disclaimer for that. But I'm going to show you some examples of disclaimer that you can use. So we have one situation, you have copyright on something. If you do not know what copyright is, I will put a link into the video. You can watch what copyright is. And on the channel, you can find a lot of videos about copyright and other stuff. So if you have copyright on something, you can put a disclaimer. But what if you use someone else? So what if you use someone else's content? How does that work? For example, if you do a review video or if you do an... let's say you use someone else's content to express something, if you use someone else's content for education. The thing is, education can be complicated. I'm not going deep into that. But what you need to know is we have the ABC formula. In a lot of videos, I talk about the ABC formula, and technically it's just this, A, B, C. And A is the right that you have. B is the person. So it can be the person. And it can be also a company, and C is the person that wants to use the right without permission, or the person that used the right without permission. So this is a third person. Yep. The thing is, sometimes when you're a copyright owner, you're allowed to decide what will happen with the right or not. But there is a law. The law say, hey, listen, in this situation, there's no copyright. Doesn't matter what you say. And one of the situations is fair use. What is fair use? I will explain that in another video, but you don't have a clear definition of what fair use is. But you have to look at the requirements. So if there is fair use, you cannot do anything about it. Understand? So this limits your right. Because when you have a copyright, you have an exclusive right. But because of the fair use, it can limit your right. So that's basic. Copyright, you can look in another video, I will explain this, but for now we need to know is if there's fair use. So when you use someone else's content, their right is limited, but you need to meet the requirement of fair use. I will make another video about that. But so this is situation number two. Number one was, what if you create something, you have copyright on it, and what can you put in your video description? Number two is, what if you use someone else's copyright? So remember, this is number two, and the other one is number one. If I talk about number one, that means the other situation. If I talk about number two, that means this situation. So let's look at some disclaimer that you can put on your website, on your YouTube channel. So if you make a content video, you have, let's say, videos, songs, or maybe image of other people in it. The thing is, you need to make sure that you meet the requirement of fair use. I will make another video about that, about the requirement of fair use. So in situation number one, you can put the following copyright disclaimer. Copyright at, put your name and the year. So if it's 2020, you put 2020. If it's 21, you put 2021. And then any reproduction or illegal distribution of the content in any form will result in immediately action against the person concerned. Really simple, you just warn them. It's just a statement. It's a disclaimer, you put it, as soon as they use something, you find out, you sue them, or you get money from them. It's that simple. Yeah. So that is for situation number one. Situation number two is also without, remember, you use someone else's content and you are sure there's fair use. For example, you make a reaction video or you review something. One of the things that you can put on it is our video, songs, image, and graphic used in the video belong to their respective owners, and I or this channel does not claim any rights over them or something. And what you can put, this is something extra, copyright disclaimer on the section 107 of the Copyright Act of 1976 allowance is made for fair use for purposes such as criticism, comment, news reporting, teaching, scholarship, education, and research. Fair use is use permit by copyright statute that might otherwise be infringement. So you see, you can put this in situation number two, but you need to make sure that you meet the requirement of the law in the US. So these are two things that you can put into your disclaimer. If you have questions about this, feel free to contact me, and I will see you in the next video.